Jullie dachten zeker dat het afgelopen was. Het verhaal van ons hertogdom Gelre. Dat alles verloren was, omdat we ooit op onze knieën gedwongen zijn door de Hollanders. We hadden natuurlijk onafhankelijk moeten blijven. Al bijna 500 jaar maakt Gelderland onrechtmatig deel uit van Nederland. Onrechtmatig! Jullie moeten mij vinden. Ga op zoek naar de verhalen van de hertoginnen van Gelre. Volg hun spoor. Vind me. Ontdek mijn geheim, koene ridders.
Een Gelderse hertogsdochter wordt koningin van Schotland. En daar stamt u vanaf.
En daar stam ik vanaf, net als 100.000 andere mensen.
Schotland?
Schotland!
Koningin van Schotland.
Gelderland. Gelre. Mijn Gelre. Ik groet u allen zeer. Kom. Reis met mij mee naar ons oude vaderland. Het hertogdom Gelre. Ooit was Gelderland een zelfstandig en vrij vorstendom. Met eigen hoofdsteden, een eigen parlement, met eigen hertogen en hertoginnen. Helaas ging ons hertogdom Gelre verloren in de golven van de geschiedenis. Al mijn hoop is gevestigd op onze ridders. Daarvoor moeten zij het spoor volgen van de hertoginnen van Gelre. Komen zij achter mijn geheim? Dan is het hertogdom Gelre misschien nog niet definitief verloren. Alles voor Gelre.
Schotland, maar hoe lang gaan we naar Schotland?
Ja, dat is de vraag natuurlijk, hè.
Ik ruim alles gewoon op.
Voor de zekerheid inderdaad maar alle sporen uitwissen, want voor je het weet vinden de Hollanders onze schuilplaats als wij in Schotland zijn. En dit is er dus, hè. Kijk, Maria, de dochter van hertog Arnold van Gelre, die koningin van Schotland wordt.
Mooie jurk.
Ja, en dit is de man, koning James van Schotland. Het staat hier ook, hè, James de Second.
Moet je het ook mee?
Nou, gooi me weg. Plakt het? Alleen die jurk is wel een beetje apart. Want het lijkt wel of ze hem zo om heeft, hè? Prachtige jurk.
Staat je goed.
Ja, mooi, hè?
Dat brengt me trouwens op een idee.
Over rokken gesproken.
Waar breng je me dan mee naartoe?
Vertrouw me nou eens.
Ja, ik vertrouw je wel, maar wat is dit? Dit heeft toch niks met Schotland te maken?
Je zit te piepen.
Ja, maar ik snap het niet.
Het heeft alles met Schotland te maken. Alles.
Hey, hallo.
Is het gelukt? Hallo.
Ja, zeker.
Is het gelukt?
Ja. Ah, hallo, René.
Ridder René, ja.
Ja, we hebben wat bij elkaar gezocht.
Oh, mooi.
Een compleet Schotse outfit. Kijk, en het zit in deze tassen.
Ah, de namen er al op.
Ja, kijk eens. Daar zit alles
in. Daar zit in wat ik vrees dat erin zit.
René?
Daar ben ik bang voor.
Daar ben ik ook bang voor.
Op naar Schotland, jongen.
Ja?
Ja. Oké. Okay.
Dit is voldoende.
Ja, Hans, je hoort van ons, hè?
Okay.
Dag, tot ziens.
Heel goed idee. Schotland.
Het land van onze Maria.
Queen of Scots.
Mary of Gelre. Incredible. Ziet er wel goed uit.
Het ruikt ook wel lekker. En ik zie hier lagers, wines en spirits.
Dit is het perfecte pub en hotel voor ons. Hey, ben er eindelijk.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Ja, het is toch morgen nog?
Goed slapen?
Als een rok.
Ik ben alvast begonnen aan het full Scottish breakfast.
Man.
Lekker, joh.
Ik heb de hele full Scottish night nog in me.
Ondertussen heb ik een beetje te lezen.
Ja.
Over Our Mary, Queen of Scots.
Ja, zeker.
En ze kwam aan toen ze trouwde in Edinburgh.
De hoofdstad.
De hoofdstad. Ze reisde helemaal zonder haar familie. Zonder hertog Arnold en haar
met
moeder
Catharina
van Kleef. Ja, hup, naar Schotland. Vanuit Sluis, daar is ze vertrokken. En
hoe lang doe je daarover eigenlijk, zo'n reis?
Nou, volgens mij heeft er wel 2 weken over gedaan.
2 weken?
Ja. En toen ze hier aankwam in Schotland, was er een enorm feest in Edinburgh.
Ja, tuurlijk.
Dus ik dacht, na het ontbijt, misschien moet jij maar naar Edinburgh.
Dat lijkt me een goed plan. Als daar het feest was, dan ga ik daarheen.
Dan blijf ik hier een beetje in de buurt om te kijken of Mary, Queen of Scots, hier ook wat voetstappen heeft achtergelaten.
Dat zal vast wel.
Ja.
Ik ben benieuwd, ja, wat er nog van te vinden is in Edinburgh. Nou.
Geen ontbijt?
Nee, ik...
Lekker, joh. Haggis? Echt hartstikke goed.
Ja.
Heeft Mary ook gegeten?
So long. Edinburgh.
In deze stad maakte Mary of Gelders, Queen of Scots, kennis met haar nieuwe vaderland. Hier trouwde ze op 3 juli 1449 en werd ze een dag later gekroond. Nog altijd is Edinburgh de trotse hoofdstad van Schotland. De Schotten verloren hun onafhankelijkheid al lang geleden, maar nog overal zie je dat de inwoners trots zijn op hun eigen identiteit. Daar kunnen wij Geldersen nog wel iets van leren. Gelderland was ooit immers ook, net als Schotland, een zelfstandig land met een eigen vorstenhuis.
Hey, Knight of Gelder, have you come back to visit Edinburgh?
You can say that. Thank you. I'm looking for Mary, Queen of Scots, but I try to imagine how did Edinburgh look like in the time she arrived here?
Well, Edinburgh's a medieval city, so it would look kind of similar as it is now. There would be the main street from the castle down to Holyrood Abbey. And Holyrood Abbey was where they had coronations and weddings of royalty.
Weddings of royalty? So she had a marriage there?
Yes, down there. And she came into Leith, which is Edinburgh's port, only a few days earlier. And when she came into the high street itself, the Royal Mile, and she travelled down part of the Royal Mile to the Abbey, the people were out cheering, and it was just a great festival day.
This is called the Royal Mile?
Yes.
How come?
Well, the Royal Mile goes from Edinburgh Castle down to the Holyrood Abbey.
And that's exactly a mile?
It's a Scottish mile, so it's slightly shorter, right. I think, than a normal mile, or an English mile as we would know it. But it's a mile, yes.
So the marriage was also here?
No, the marriage was down at the bottom of the Royal Mile where the Abbey is. They were married in the Abbey.
In that Abbey?
In that Abbey there, yes.
And our Mary of Gelders is married there?
She was married there, yes, to James II.
And how was this marriage like?
Well, she was a 16-year-old girl. He was 18, but remember, he was king. He was quite a sort of tough guy. Has to be a tough guy, because even at that young age, you know, you have to make sure that you're going to lead the country. So she was seen as being very pretty and be a lovely girl.
Yeah.
He had a birthmark on the side of his face.
Like Gorbachev.
Well, yes, moved down a bit.
Yeah, right.
And so he was known as James of the Fiery Face.
James of the Fiery Face.
But
and she just met three, four, 5 days before they married?
They met that day. They met that day. They hadn't met before. It had been arranged previously and agreed previously, and then she came into our port of Leith and then came up here.
And then she saw this mark on his face.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the man I love.
That's the man I want to be with.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And the people here, were they celebrating?
People were celebrating in the streets here, and obviously people were celebrating within the Abbey itself. She was wearing a long gown of violet and ermine. Her hair was down. It was described as being unusual and peculiar.
Peculiar, yeah.
Particularly against a French style of
wearing clothes. Oh yeah, that's her Burgundian roots,
yes.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Gelder Burgundian.
Yeah.
So we walked down the end of the Royal Mile. We are now?
Yes, at the foot of the Royal Mile.
Yeah.
And that's the approach through towards the Abbey.
But let's go into the Abbey then.
Well, we're not allowed to go into the Abbey because it is a royal residence.
It's royal residence?
Yeah, we're not allowed to go in.
Also, not for me as a Knight of Gelder, I can't go in?
Sadly not.
Sadly not. It's our Mary from Gelders.
It is. But it's our Queen Elizabeth II that lives here, and she needs to be secured.
Yeah, but the blood of Mary of Gelders is also in the veins of Elizabeth.
I'm quite sure it is.
We related.
Yes.
And we can't go in.
No.
It's a pity we can't go in.
Well, we can't go in because of security reasons. That's the reason.
I'm not that dangerous.
I'm quite sure.
I bring something. I bring back the history.
Na haar huwelijk in Edinburgh woonde onze Gelderse Queen Mary vooral hier op het kasteel van Stirling. Hier zie je de macht en rijkdom van de Schotse koningen. Ze hadden een groot aantal kastelen in hun bezit, maar het liefst woonden James en Mary hier. Op Stirling Castle loop je echt in de voetsporen van onze Mary of Gelders, Queen of Scots.
Good morning, sir. Welcome to Stirling Castle.
Thank you very much.
It's quite a place, isn't it?
This is the place where our Queen Mary, Mary of Galway, lived?
Yes, indeed. This is one of the major royal residences in Scotland, dating way back to the 1100s. So Mary of Gelders spent a lot of time here when she was Queen of Scots.
It's a little bit the Versailles Palace of Scotland.
Very much so. Well, I'm biased. I would say it's even nicer than Versailles Palace in its own unique way. The castle has been developed over the centuries, so much of what we have here today is slightly later than Mary of Gelders. Her grandson, King James IV, did most to give the castle its present appearance. But we have some structures, the North Gate, the old chapel, which Mary of Gelders would have experienced when she was here.
But this gateway was built by the grandson of our Mary, Queen of Scots?
That's exactly it. Mary of Gelders' grandson, King James IV, our great Renaissance king, built this entrance to the castle around 1500.
So our Mary got a lot of children.
She gave birth 7 times.
7?
In fact, the very first child of the marriage between King James II of Scotland and Mary of Gelders was born here.
Was born here.
Stirling Castle. So she more than provided for the throne of Scotland.
Yeah, exactly. She was very important for Scotland.
She was indeed. And of course it was her son, her third child, James III.
He became the King of Scotland.
He becomes the king. So yeah, she's important. She's very, very important in our history.
I want to see more.
You're more than welcome.
You're my guide.
Come on, we'll see the Renaissance grandeur of Stirling Castle.
What a view.
It is quite spectacular, isn't it?
It's spectacular.
It's a beautiful setting. And down below us, we have one of the best preserved royal landscapes in Scotland. In fact, we can link this into the marriage of James II to Mary of Gelders. For down below us, in what we call the Haring Field, there was a famous jousting tournament in February 1449. And we think almost certainly that tournament was linked to the negotiations between Scotland and Burgundy for the marriage between James II and Mary of Gelders. 3 Burgundian knights came here to Stirling, led by Jacques de la Laine. And down below the castle, they fought, in the presence of King James II, 3 Scottish knights. The Burgundians won 3-0. However, despite the glamour of the tournament, behind the scenes, negotiations were underway for the marriage of James to Mary of Gelders. And after the Burgundians left, of course, Arnold, Duke of Gelders, concluded the marriage contract for his daughter to wed the King of Scots. Much of the negotiations took place down here below Stirling Castle.
So it was here where Mary became the Queen of Scots.
Essentially, the final details of that marriage were concluded here in Stirling.
The negotiations took place here.
That's it. That's what we believe in the February of 1449.
Now we are really in the footsteps of our Mary of Galway.
Very much so. This is the oldest building in the castle we're about to approach. It dates back to 1381. So when Mary of Gelders were here, this was a gateway that she would have used.
And she came here a lot of times?
Oh, yeah. I mean, she's Queen of Scots from 1449 until 1463, so a lot of that time spent here at Stirling Castle.
Did she have a favourite spot in the castle?
Well, I would think, given that she's the Queen of Scots, mm-hmm. most of her time here would be spent in the royal heart of the castle, the King's House, the Queen's House, the Chapel Royal. If you like, I'm more than happy to take you up and let you see that area.
I'd love to.
This way. We're now standing in a courtyard called the Inner Close, and this is the royal heart of Stirling Castle. So around us here, we have arguably the finest collection of royal buildings that you'll find anywhere in Scotland. And we know that Mary of Guelders lived in a building called the Queen's House, and we think the Queen's House was on this site. So this essentially is where Mary of Guelders would have lived when she was based in the castle.
Over here, this is the spot.
Rough location, not specifically this building that we see today, but there are structures within this building that would date from her time. This is essentially where she lived.
And King James, where did he live?
James II would have lived on the higher point of the rock, a structure called the King's House, or in Scots, the King's Hoose.
Hoose? Oh, that's like in Dutch.
Just in Dutch. Yeah. We have very strong similarities. So James II at the top of the rock in the King's Hoose, and Mary of Guelders here, slightly to the south, in the Queen's Hoose.
But sometimes they were together because they got seven children.
Of course. Seven times she gave birth.
Yeah.
So of course they would spend a lot of time. It does seem to have been a very happy marriage.
Okay, that's great.
It was a very positive match between James II, King of Scots, mm-hmm. and Mary, Duchess of Guelders.
I'm so happy she was happily married here in Scotland.
Why could you not be? When you see beautiful surroundings like this and the sun always shining in Scotland, why wouldn't she be happy?
Mary of Guelders is home again.
She is home again.
In Stirling Castle.
That's it, the arms of Guelders once more, flying above the castle at Stirling.
Die Queen Elizabeth die kam uit. Ik ben stiekem toch even in de Holyrood Abbey gaan kijken waar onze Mary of Guelders is getrouwd. En nu gaan we naar Edinburgh Castle.
So this is the castle.
This is the castle. And that's the royal apartments up on your left hand side where the gold paint is above the windows.
So this is the castle.
Yeah.
Where our Mary of Guelders lived?
Well, she didn't live here. She would have visited here. She would have maybe held receptions here. It's more likely that she was in Stirling Castle more often. And she gave birth to one of her children in Stirling Castle as well. So she was through there more often.
What does remember her here?
Ah, well, a wedding gift she received from the Duke of Burgundy. And it was a field cannon.
A wedding gift is a cannon.
A cannon, yeah. Very large, 7 tons in weight. It's 4.6 meters long. It has a diameter of 51 centimeters. It's a very large cannon.
And people gave it for a wedding present?
Well, Mary's uncle was the Duke of Burgundy, and he knew that James liked artillery. He liked to be in battle, and artillery was his thing. So that was part of the reason that they gave him that gift.
Speaking of James,
yeah.
What happened after his death?
James was killed on the battlefield. He died in 1416 at the siege of Roxburgh Castle. He needed to try and protect his lands, firstly internally, but then against the English. And they held Roxburgh Castle. So he was besieging that castle. Sadly, one of the cannons that he had at that time, not Mons Meg, but another a cannon he had there, exploded and killed him.
Oh, he was killed by his own cannon?
He was killed by his own cannon.
And after this sad death of
yes.
James, what happened to Mary of Guelders?
Well, she was looking after her son, who became king, but he was so young that she looked after him and advised him, and as such was Queen of Scotland at that time, yeah. with there being no adult king.
She ruled.
She ruled until he grew up.
As a widow.
As a widow.
Go inside.
Come in.
So where we are now, we're in the palace of King James V. He's obviously the great grandson of Mary of Guelders. And these are the Queen's apartments. So they're decorated today as they would have looked in the 1540s when Mary of Guise was here at Stirling Castle, bringing up another Mary Queen of Scots, young Mary Stuart.
Yeah, but our Mary Queen of Scots lived here as well when she was in Stirling Castle.
She would have been here at Stirling Castle, not specifically within this building, but in a building on this site. Mm-hmm. That's where the Queen's House would have been during the time of Mary of Guelders.
Mr. Ross, you see this?
Ah, you've noticed.
That's the sign of Mary.
That's
our
exactly it.
Queen Mary of Galway.
This is the coat of arms of Mary of Guise, and of course she had a connection with the Duchy of Guelders, hence its incorporation in her crest.
They remember our Mary of Galway here in Stirling Castle.
Why could you not?
Now I'm convinced.
Such an important figure. Let's see the bedchamber.
Mary of Galway, she became a regent after the death of her husband.
That's exactly it. Her husband dies quite dramatically at the Siege of Roxburgh in early August 1460. Thereafter, Mary of Guelders becomes regent of Scotland and heads up the Scottish government.
She rules Scotland?
She does, essentially.
By herself?
Well, the first thing she has to do is have her son crowned. And she does that. Young James, Duke of Rossi, is crowned at the Abbey of Kelso on the 10th of August, 1460. And then the Queen becomes the guardian of the young king, and she becomes the head of the government. So she doesn't govern on her own.
And this was the bedroom?
Well, this was the bedroom of the Queen of Scots during the time of Mary of Guise, when she was here. So it means something similar to that that Mary of Guelders would have enjoyed when she was resident at the castle. And what it does give you an indication is the fact that Scotland is not a remote and barbarous land. This is a civilised European court, and Mary of Guelders, of course, would have graced that court with her European elan.
And she was a regent.
She was a regent. She's a very, very important figure governing the country.
She was quite young. She was 27 when she became regent, and she died after 3 years.
Yes.
Here in this bed?
No, of course not. She died on the 1st of December, 1463. And although she was here at Stirling Castle often, it wasn't here in Stirling Castle that she died. We're not sure where she died exactly. There's a possibility it may have been at the castle of Ravenscraig.
Ravenscraig?
Ravenscraig, over at Dysart and Fife.
Ravenscraig was a place where she came a lot of times during her last years of her life.
She was building that castle. She spent a lot of money in the construction of it. So it's a castle that is very, very closely associated with the last years of Mary of Guelders' time here in Scotland.
Ravenscraig.
Nou, moet het hier toch zijn. Ravenscraig Castle.
Hey, wat een plek.
Goh, hier is ze dus gewoon echt gewoond, hè?
Ja, heb je het bord gezien?
Ja.
Waar ze op staat, hier gewoon. Ze begroet ons gewoon als we binnenkomen.
Met de vlag, als jurk.
In haar kasteel, want dit kasteel heeft zij gebouwd.
Ja, dat is ongelooflijk.
En ik snap het wel, maar moet je nou kijken.
Ravenscraig.
Moet je nou kijken, wat een uitzicht vanaf hier. Hier heeft ze gewoon de laatste 2 jaar van haar leven over de zee uitgekeken. Terwijl ze regentesse was, hè?
Als oude vrouw?
Nee, niet oud, hè?
Nee, niet oude vrouw.
Ze was pas 30 toen ze overleed. Ja. Hartstikke jong. Er heeft gewoon een Gelderse vrouw geregeerd over Schotland als regentes.
Laat dat maar eens even tot je doordringen.
Vanuit dit kasteel. En het was ook een supermodern kasteel dat ze hier bouwde, hè, in haar tijd. Heb je nu die muren gezien?
Ja, die muren, daar komt geen kogel doorheen.
Echt voor het eerst een kasteel waar de kanonskogels niet doorheen kwamen. Heeft zij bedacht. Gewoon een vrouw van 28, 29.
En zo zie je hoe belangrijk die Gelderse hertoginnen zijn voor onze geschiedenis.
Ja, en ook voor de Schotse geschiedenis. Ja,
ongelooflijk toch?
Ja. Maar als ze hier gewoond heeft, hè, de laatste jaren van haar leven. Ja. Ze is niet oud geworden.
Nou, dan denk ik ook bij mezelf.
Dan zou het zomaar kunnen zijn dat we hier op de goede plek zijn.
Voor het doosje van de hertogin.
Ja.
Als jij er naar daar kijkt, bij de grote toren, dan ga ik een beetje richting de zee.
De zee?
Ja.
Ik denk dat het daar ligt, hoor.
Misschien. Kijk, achter die muur.
Het ligt natuurlijk hier. Naar de zee.
Niks gevonden?
Nee.
Nee, ik ook niet.
Ik zit me af te vragen. Ze is hier natuurlijk wel oud geworden. Maar is er nog misschien een andere plek waar ze nog ouder geworden is?
Nou ja, ze heeft hier de laatste jaren van haar leven doorgebracht, hè?
Misschien heeft ze daarna, of misschien is ze later ook nog ergens gewoond.
Nou, ik zie wel dat ze in Edinburgh begraven is, in een kerk.
Een kerk in Edinburgh.
Trinity Church. Zeg je dat iets? Heb je die gezien?
Nee, ik kan me niet zo gauw voor de geest halen.
Dat is haar laatste rustplaats.
Edinburgh.
Ja, zie ik het ook nog eens.
So long, Mary. Wat een kasteel.
Nou, mooi, Edinburgh.
Schitterend.
Weet je, ik heb trouwens ook gelezen dat onze Mary of Galre, die kreeg nog een begrafenis in Arnhem in de Eusebiuskerk van haar vader, hertog Arnold. Dat is wel bijzonder, hè?
Dat is heel bijzonder, ja.
Maar hier is ze begraven.
Maar hier is ze toch begraven?
Ja.
Maar dat zou dan... Hier zat dan toch de Trinity Church?
Ja. De Holy Trinity Church. Moet hier ergens zijn.
Ja, dat moet hier zijn, maar... Het ziet... Dat is een toren.
Dat ja, dat is hem niet. Het moet hier zijn. Hier moet die kerk gestaan hebben. De kerk waar
onze hertogin begraven is. De koningin van Schotland.
Onze Queen of Scots.
Ik zie alleen maar treintjes rijden.
Ik ga het even vragen.
Ja?
Ja.
Nee, niet gevonden?
Het is een station. Ze hebben in 1848 de kerk waar Maria begraven is afgebroken. Ze heeft een herbegrafenis gekregen in Holyrood Abbey.
Ben ik geweest.
Ben je geweest, toch?
Niks gezien. Nou ja, misschien niet goed gekeken, maar... En nu dan? Ik bedoel...
Ik weet echt niet meer waar we het doosje van de hertogin nu moeten vinden. En het geheim van de hertogin zit op een doodspoor.
Ik kan alleen maar denken aan een heel groot glas whisky. De Trinity College Church founded, dat staat hier ook gewoon. Precies, er zit maar één ding op. Arms. Van Mary of Gelders. Mary of Gelders.
Queen of Scots.
De ridders zitten in Schotland helemaal op het verkeerde spoor. Ze reizen terug naar Nederland en moeten op zoek naar een nieuwe schuilplaats. De Hollandse Veiligheidsdienst heeft ons in de gaten. De ridders storten zich op het leven van hertogin Catharina van Bourbon. Gaan de ridders verder op de goede weg? Op zoek naar het geheim van de hertogin? Zie het volgende week.
Ja.
Voelt wel helemaal goed, zo keelt.
Fantastisch. En omdat een van onze hertoginnen koningin van Schotland is geweest...
hebben we Schotse ochtend, komende zaterdag.
Hier in Borculo.
Borculo, want het is een beetje de Schotse hoofdstad van Gelre.
Ja, in ieder geval een Schotse enclave.
Ja, het wordt een ongelofelijk feest om je waantje hier helemaal in Schotland. Komende zaterdag, net als onze Gelderse hertogin.
Ja, ik denk dat er na je oren ook nog steeds denken dat je in Schotland bent.
Het wordt fantastisch. Maak het mee, komende zaterdag. Gelredag, maar dan met een Schots tintje. Nou, Schotse tint. Ik heb er wel weer zin in.
Je bent er zo snel aan, hè?